Hi everyone, Darren from DrayTek Australia and New Zealand. In our last video, we discussed replacing the router that the ISP supplied to connect to the NBN service if it didn't do everything we needed it to, and what to do to retain the existing phone service, which was now locked to the ISP's supplied router instead of plugged into the old copper phone line system. In this video, I'll go through the configuration of the DrayTek router and placing the ISP's supplied router in the DMZ to continue using it for the voice over IP service so we don't lose the phone number. So starting with the configuration on the DrayTek. In this example, I'm using a hybrid fiber coaxial NBN connection. Assuming you already know your ISP username and password, the first step is to disconnect the ISP's router from the HFC modem and plug the modem into the WAN port of the DrayTek router, which in this example is a DrayTek Vigor 2762. The Ethernet WAN port on the DrayTek Vigor 2762 is a special port, port 4, that we can use either as a WAN port to connect to the internet or as a LAN port we can plug one of our PCs or other devices into. Now to get started, plug a PC into one of the LAN ports of the DrayTek. Now log into the DrayTek router and go to WAN General Setup. You'll need to tick the box to enable WAN 2 if it isn't already. WAN 2 is our Ethernet WAN port. Now go to Internet Access. Our NBN ISP uses a PPPoE login in this case, so we select PPPoE from the pull-down menu, then select Details page. We need to enable it and then enter the ISP username and password. Click OK and then check the online status back on the dashboard page and we should be online within a few seconds. If you're not online, it could be that your ISP requires a VLAN tag. I'll come back to that shortly. One thing we'll also need to do is change the LAN subnet of the DrayTek so it doesn't match the ISP router's LAN subnet. Technically, you could do this on either router, but I had issues getting the routers to see each other when I did that on my ISP's router, so I recommend changing things on the ISP router as little as possible. So we go to LAN, General Setup, Details page. The default is 192.168.1.something. Here's one I prepared earlier by changing it to 192.168.10.1. Click OK and it'll prompt to reboot. Once it does, to log back in, you'll now need to go to 192.168.10.1. Now I'll make a few changes to our ISP router before we plug it into the DrayTek router. First, we'll unplug our PC from the DrayTek and plug it into the ISP router and log in. Most routers use admin by default. Once in, we'll need to find the settings for the Ethernet WAN port, which in this case is in the Advanced section and down here under Network called eWAN. We want to change it to a static IP and give it an IP address within the range of the DrayTek router's LAN subnet, which is now 192.168.10.something. Let's go with 192.168.10.10. The default gateway is the DrayTek router's IP address, which is now 192.168.10.1. And the primary DNS can be the same unless you have another DNS server address you prefer, such as Google's. Save that and let it reboot if it prompts to. You might also want to disable the ISP router's Wi-Fi as well if that's not going to be used. Now we can go ahead and connect the ISP router's WAN port to one of the DrayTek router LAN ports. Handy tip, if we leave our PC connected to the ISP's router now, we'll be able to log into either router without having to manually plug and unplug each time we need to switch. Now to create our DMZ host for our ISP router to use, log back into the DrayTek router, remember it's now on 192.168.10.1, and go to NAT DMZ host. In this case, remember our internet connection is on WAN 2, so we select the WAN 2 tab here. Enable it and type in our ISP router's IP address, which we decided would be 192.168.10.10, and click OK. Now, that IP address is inside our DrayTek router's DHCP pool. So to prevent a possible IP address conflict from occurring on our network, we need to lock it down to ensure no other device can accidentally grab it. We do that either by changing the DHCP pool so the 192.168.10.10 address isn't in it, by changing the start IP address to 192.168.10.20, for example. The only problem with this method is you'll need to now remember you did that if you ever manually assign static IP addresses to any other devices on your network. A better way is to use the bind IP to MAC facility down here. All connected devices are displayed in the ARP table here, so we just select the one we want, which is the ISP router we've set at 192.168.10.10, click Add and click OK. Now, that IP address is locked to that MAC address and nothing else can take it. One other thing we should do is set QoS for VoIP. Go to Bandwidth Management, Quality of Service, and tick this box under VoIP Prioritization. Enable the first priority for VoIP SIP RTP. And click OK and reboot if it prompts to. I'll also just mention here that some VoIP service providers like Telstra also require outbound VoIP packets to be tagged, which we can do down here using the Add DSCP or Precedence Value menu option. This ensures the VoIP traffic is prioritised from end to end in the Telstra network. Without it, Telstra will treat it as normal data with no particular prioritisation, which can result in choppy audio and phone calls. So for this, all we need to do is enable it for Class 1, and in the case of Telstra, select EF Class from the pull-down menu, then click OK to save it. If we log back into the ISP router now and go to the dashboard page, we should see internet status as showing as connected, and also see that the phone is online. Job done. That's basically all there is to it. However, one final aspect I mentioned earlier that we need to address is that many ISPs also use a VLAN tag to authenticate, and we need to enter that somewhere if we want to get online. Going back to the Vigor 2762, let's assume we're with TPG, which uses a VLAN tag of 2. Other ISPs might require a different number. Without that VLAN tag, to enter a VLAN tag on a DrayTek router's WAN port, go to WAN, General Setup. Select WAN 2 in this example for hybrid fiber coaxial, but if you're using VDSL, it would be on WAN 1. Enable VLAN tag insertion and set tag value as 2, or whatever it may be that your ISP uses. Click OK and then go back to the dashboard page and voila, now we're online. Log back into the ISP router and we find it's also online. However, if we check the phone status, we have a problem. Now what's happening here is the security settings for that VoIP account must also need to see that VLAN tag on this router. To get that happening, we need to do two things. First, we need to set it on the WAN connection for the ISP router. So go back to Advanced, Network Settings and select eWAN again. And all we need to do here is tick Enable for VLAN ID, enter 2 or whatever tag your ISP uses, and save. And then set it on the LAN settings on our DrayTek. Log back into the DrayTek and go to LAN, VLAN and click Enable. Now for VLAN 0, which will be our main local area network, we'll tick port 2 and port 3, plus any wireless SSIDs we have. You may notice port 4 is missing here, and that's because port 4 is configured as our WAN port in this example. Then for VLAN 1, we'll tick the box under port 1, enable VLAN tag and enter a VID of 2 and click OK. Now anything plugged into port 1 will get a VLAN tag of 2, so we need to make sure the ISP router is plugged into port 1, and then log back into it to see if we've been successful. We might have to give the ISP router a reboot at this point, but when it comes back up, we should have phone and internet all working happily. If you don't, switch both routers and the NBN connection box off and back on again, and it should all come to life. So what we have here now is a VLAN tag of 2 on the WAN port of our internet-facing DrayTek router. We have the same VLAN tag on the dedicated DMZ port, and we have the same VLAN tag on the WAN port of our ISP's router behind the DrayTek. Okay, for more detail about this procedure, including a table showing which routers are compatible with each type of NBN, I'll include a link to our blog article on the same topic in the description below. For more information about DrayTek products, please check out our website at www.draytek.com.au. If you have any questions, please comment below, or you can send us an email to sales@draytek.com.au or give us a call on 02 9838 8899. Don't forget to like and subscribe below and give the bell a click if you'd like a notification of new videos as they go up. Thanks and bye for now.